Welcome to another installment of Eagles on the Air. I'm Mike Wyattrack, and here's what's been happening. The Physical Education Department recently concluded their in-class square dance contest. This hoedown was fun for all the participants and allowed students to approach exercise in a fun and danceable way. Congratulations to the winners in each block. Just in time for the spring musical, the auditorium received an upgrade to their lighting system.
Very excited about the new lighting system. We have a whole new system, new instruments, a new lighting board, new circuitry, new dimmers. It's really going to give us the chance to get a lot more light on the stage, have a lot more control over the light that we do have. I have loved Evita since I was 15 years old, the first time I heard the show. We're trying to do something a little bit different with it. What we're trying is to use actual pictures of Evita and the locations that are in the play. We're blowing them up very large black and white copies of them, and so we sort of have a black and white palette that we're working with, and then we're gonna have the costumes and things inside is where the color is gonna come from.
The marine biology classes recently visited the Camden Aquarium. The trip offered students an opportunity to see marine life up close and in person. We caught up with Mike Hopkins, who was on the trip, and here's what he had to say.
My favorite part about the aquarium was probably the shark tunnel and just the overall experience I had there. There was a lot of hands-on stuff like petting the sharks and petting the stingrays. And overall, it was just, you know, it was a really good time.
Miss O'Hare recently had her students examine and apply the principles of kinetic energy in her scaled aviation class by test flying their planes in the hallways. Let's take a look.
For this project, my students were constructing a Wright Flyer plane to test the kinetic and potential energy in the rubber band engine and to see how that affected the flight distance.
So we built these planes in Ms. O'Hare's scaled aviation class, and basically we built these to demonstrate potential and kinetic energy, the potential energy being stored in the rubber band when you wind it, and the kinetic energy being produced when you actually fly it.
And we created hypotheses to judge how far the plane would go with 30 winds, 60 winds, and 90 winds. And we thought that it would go farther each time the winds increased.
I was excited to see how into the project they got. They became very competitive to see who could have the longest flight distance, and they're currently remodeling it to see if they can make it better.
Dr. George recently stopped by Middletown High School South to discuss the facilities referendum with Aisha Bori.
Is this referendum tied to a redistricting proposal?
That's another question that I'm frequently answering, mm-hmm. And the answer is no. Actually, the referendum, as it is proposed, is to upgrade and address these critical need projects, the roofing projects and the heating and cooling in 15 of our schools. And that needs to be done for us to continue to deliver our programs and our services the way we are currently.
The facilities referendum passed with a majority vote of about 70%, so the much-needed building repairs can begin, thanks to all the voters who turned out. Congratulations to the following film and TV students: Shane O'Neill, Sarah Camiotti, Dylan McCormick, Joe Luther, Gary Sisk, Izel Sorzano, and Ryan Guerrero. Two of their films have been selected to be screened at the Kent Place School Film Festival, which will take place on Friday, March 28th in Summit, New Jersey. The event is in its sixth year, and it attracts aspiring filmmakers from all over the state. The Middletown High School South Marching Band participated in this year's St. Patrick's Day Parade in New York City. It's the parade's 252nd year, and it's going stronger than ever. The American Heart Association would like to give a special thanks to Jessica LaRocca, Katrina Pallaire, Matt Gray, Tom Marinello, and Evan Becker for helping to make Hoops for Heart such a huge success this year. They set a new school record, raising $1,436, which is double the amount that they raised last year. Thanks to everyone who donated to the American Heart Association. Congratulations to the Hoops for Heart 3-on-3 tournament champs as well. Winners of the 3-on-3 were Luke Benigno, JP Fleming, Alex Marusik, Drew O'Connell, Kyle Bray, and Pat Crow. Ms. Santori's class recently took a field trip to the Franklin Institute in Philadelphia in order to visit the Pompeii exhibit. The exhibit featured items from the town's ruins, replicas of the preserved victims, and an immersive experience of the eruption itself. South's Amnesty International chapter, along with the National Honor Society from both North and South, hosted Rocking for the Philippines. The Milltown Benefit concert took place on February 27th at Milltown North's Theater. The benefit was held in order to raise money for victims of Typhoon Haiyan. Bands and performers from both North and South provided entertainment and civic awareness. Let's take a look at what the chapter has done this year.
Amnesty International is an organization that basically promotes human rights all around the globe, and its main goal and purpose is to galvanize change, whether that's through helping out prisoners of conscience who are suppressed by their governments, or people who don't have human rights, or people in the Philippines who have to live in poverty because of a typhoon. And this is our first year at South, and thanks to our tireless advisor, Ms. Tirso, we've been really starting off on a great foot. We planted seagrass at a local beach as part of the Restore the Shore project. We've constructed a playground at a local community YMCA to aid Red Bank children. We've lobbied congressmen for women's rights, and most recently we hosted Rockin' for the Philippines, a benefit concert, and raised more than $1,500 to help victims devastated by Typhoon Haiyan. And we saw that the typhoon Haiyan had impacted the Philippines in November. So we were trying to think of a way to best help them out, and then we came up with the idea of a benefit concert. We knew great musicians like Zach Alexander and Kara Intercrasso, and so we decided to put all the talents that we had at South together and basically galvanize change. Then I was talking to the North's National Honor Society, and we decided to put both organizations together, and then we've been collaborating for the past few months.
I think it's really cool that us kids in Middletown as performers can get together for a good cause and play music, because nothing is more powerful than a good song and good energy on stage. I've seen tons of concerts myself, and one of the best ones I saw was the Global Citizen Festival, which was for a nonprofit charity organization, and I saw some great bands, Foo Fighters, Neil Young, Band of Forces for free, and I'm glad that I can do something similar to that to give back to an organization just as beneficial.
Amnesty International now is starting with this great concert and all these different charitable events. So I'm excited to see what else they can do, because this is only the first year that this chapter has been inducted to South. So I'm very excited to see what's going to happen and what's going to go on in the future.
Great work for a good cause. Finally, we'll leave you with a look at the art department here at South. I'm Mike Wyattrack, and have a great day.
The art department is special because it's a place where people can be really creative and express themselves. So not only do we teach about art history and different kinds of methods of art and different kinds of materials, we also teach people how to be expressive and how to be confident in what their decisions are and whether they have a strong aesthetic and how they view things. So we really try to create a very like open and fun environment, but at the same time we really focus on a lot of the meat and potatoes of art.
Well, I think that the art department as a whole offers students a place to be creative and a place to have divergent creativity and divergent thinking. There's not usually one answer that is right and answers that are wrong. A lot of times you can be creative and find your own way to the answer. And I think that's really important, because there aren't a lot of classes, subject matter, where that's possible.